for measuring the V offset voltage, right? So first, this is my 741, this is my positive bias, the black one is my negative bias, and the blue one is ground, right? So first we'll do the biasing. For biasing, pin number 7 is positively biased at plus 15 volts. So connect pin number 7 to plus 15 volts. Then pin number 4 is at minus 15 volts. So connect pin number 4 at minus 15 volts. Right? Okay. And now we'll have to ground it. So if you remember the circuit, right, what we are going to do is we are going to ground both inverting and non-inverting terminals. So let's first directly ground the non-inverting terminal, that is pin number 3, right? So this is done, and now we are not going to use it in the open loop mode, because then the gain is very, very large and any small imbalance will lead the IC to saturation. So basically we are not going to measure anything other than the saturation voltage. So what we'll do is, instead of that, we will make a 1000 gain amplifier, right? Now how do you make a 1000 gain negative feedback amplifier? So the feedback resistor I am choosing as 100 kilo ohms. So between pin number 6 and 2, 6 is the output, 2 is the inverting input, and then between 2 and ground I am putting a 100 ohms resistor, right? So that will make a 1000 gain negative feedback amplifier, right? Okay, now this is done. Now what we have to do is, since we are not giving input to any of the inverting or the non-inverting pins, that means I have a grounded inputs, right? Whatever voltage I see across at pin number 6 is going to be the output offset voltage, and then we'll divide it by the gain and we'll get output input offset voltage. So for that, let me put the multimeter in DC voltage mode and then measure the output at pin number 6. Okay. So now, as you can see, the output at pin number 6 is about 10.6 volts, right? What that means is that the output offset voltage is 10.6, and correspondingly the input offset voltage is of the order of 10.6 by 1000, right? So about 10.6 millivolts, right? Now we'll make a null circuit to nullify this. How do we make a null circuit to nullify this, right? So if you see in your manual, what we do is we take a 10 kilo ohm potentiometer pot, right? Okay, and then we connect its two extreme ends or fixed resistance ends to pin number 1 and pin number 5, which are the offset null pins. Okay, and the variable resistance pin I'll connect to negative bias or minus 15 volts, right? And as you can see, the output offset voltage already starts to change because of the potential difference between pin number 1 and pin number 5, right? And now using the pot, we'll try to reduce it further. So from 10.6 volts, it has come down to 150 millivolt. And if I move the pot, I can see that it's changing, right? Let me bring the pot here. We can see that it's changing, right? And we can reduce it to very low values. So let's try to bring it to as close to zero as possible. So maybe I'll leave it here. So of course we won't be able to nullify completely, right? But we can come in the range of few tens of millivolts, and that's the output offset voltage. So corresponding to that, the input offset voltage now goes into microvolts, right? So that's a change of almost 3 orders of magnitude, and that will be good enough.